This is the story of a king. And this was a good king. He was kind to his servants. He was kind to everybody who lived in his kingdom. He provided for every one of their needs, but the people were not so kind to the king in return. In fact, they formed a coup to rebel and kick the king off of his throne. They stormed the castle, but the king was strong. The king was mighty. He defended his throne, and the rebels scattered back out into the woods. But the king was so kind and had so much compassion, he desired to restore the rebels to a right relationship with himself. The king, in order to do that, he sent a messenger or messengers to proclaim good news to the rebels. Now, here is the question. Can you imagine if the messengers went out and proclaimed that good news to the rebels like this? Number one, the king has a wonderful plan for your life. What? Can you imagine what the king has? Hey, rebels, the king has a wonderful plan for your life. That really doesn't get to the heart of the king's message, does it? Here are some other messages of the messengers. You have a king-shaped hole in your heart that only the king can fill, rebel. Number three, the king will help you raise happier children. Number four, you've tried sex, you've tried drugs, and you've tried rock and roll. Why not try the king? Satirical, yes, but painful also, because haven't you and I been guilty of presenting the message of the king like this? We've perhaps presented the benefits of the gospel, but we haven't presented the gospel itself. More messages, bad ones from the messengers. Hey, rebels, it's nicer to live in the king's castle. He's got better food. Number six, close your eyes and repeat after me, rebels, while I play emotional music about the king. How many times have we done that? Nobody's intending to confuse the rebels, but we've lost sight of the gospel message. Jesus died for sinners, and you are commanded this day to repent. Wrong message from the messengers. Number seven, the king will make you rich. Number eight, the king will make your flu go away. Number nine, the king will give you purpose. And finally, imagine if the messenger said, the king is just nuts about you, and he can't live without you. All right. Satirical, yes, guilty. I've done these myself. You probably have too. And while we can laugh at these, it's really not a laughing matter. Why? Because the consequences are deadly. The consequences are eternal when you and I fail to rightly deliver the message of the king.